you are not living in confidence, in divine confidence, in divine boldness, you are malfunctioning. Am I communicating to us?
Yes, sir.
I remember one certain time I was traveling from Abuja to Benin. On our way, armed robbers just were laid out. Some were in front, some were at the back. I remember I was reading Kennedy book that day. Inside the bus, everybody was panicking. I was as calm as Jesus was in that boat. People were shouting and shouting and shouting. I was enjoying what I was studying. I didn't move an inch. Not even any shake in my heart. You don't understand what I'm saying? The way we escaped them, I didn't know. After we escaped, a woman by the side said that this man that is sitting here, when I saw him, she had left him. I just saw him, he was so calm and so quiet here, just left me. Somehow was ignorant and necessity for heaven. But God was not efficient to see. Making mention of you in my prayer, that God the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, the Father of glory, may give unto the Spirit of wisdom. I said, seated.
Hallelujah.
So I was seated, far above all this while, I've been afraid. All this while, I live in fear. But I was seated far above. Bang, I caught the light. Like I was sharing to you, it was on a particular day that I saw that scripture from this. In all of these things, I am more than conqueror through him that strengthens me. You know the one I also, when they brought him before Agrippa, from what God has made me a God of our own. Now one of them, they saw, they said, you left nothing. It was a careful. And I said to him that, I'm not from the kingdom of darkness. I don't know anything there. I am ambassador of heaven, so I talk about heaven. Ambassador of China, Nigeria, talk about China. I'm ambassador of Ghana, talk about Ghana. What must I be talking about? Well, there's one black witch. There's one witch they call Asmodi. I don't need all those things. A friend was telling me, a pastor friend, one witch called Asmodi. He was teaching what they call demonology or worship.
Yes.
One as Asmodi, this and this and this. I said, I don't care the name whatsoever is the name, at the name of Jesus the Lord.
Mm-hmm.
Even if they say black witch, white witch, red witch, I said, whether green or whatsoever color, even if they keep promoting them day by day, none of them can be promoted above the truth. None. So I eternally live in supremacy about the work of darkness. You shall be far from operation. That what I said, so in the Old Testament. Then in the New, they now say to you, you are far above. Not miles above. Not kilometers above. It can't be measured. The distance, you are far. That's why when you understand this, you live in the state of imperturbability. Nothing perturbs you. You live in the peace of God. You live in the peace. Romans 5:1. Having been justified, we have peace. Sometimes we read this thing to cramp it. It wasn't to read to cramp, it's to become our life. Jeremiah saw it in the old. In Jeremiah chapter 3 from verse 6, he said, I will reveal to them abundance of peace. Then I said to the saints, thou shalt keep them in the perfect peace. Pastor, whose mind stays on God? Philippians 4:7, and the peace of God that passes all understanding. That understanding that is troubling, you said the peace of God is a peace that passes it. We can't receive our soul. Psalm 119, verse 165. They that know the Lord, great peace shall be. Great peace. I'll close by saying this. The reason why you don't know these things is because you don't know there's something available for you.
Yes.
Paul said, be careful for nothing. Why if I tell you be careful for nothing, it means there's something that is making me to tell you be careful for nothing. Huh? You don't understand? You don't understand? Somebody asked me some time ago, in some years, as a Christian, you need deliverance. I said yes. Some people have accused me severally that Pastor Douglas would not believe in me. I said no, I believe in deliverance. But not the way you believe, Pastor Paul. I believe it by the scriptures. The Bible says by knowledge, the church shall deliver. I understand deliverance by knowledge. What set me free from sickness and affliction and fear is knowledge. I don't think there's anything in the universe that can impose an iota of fear on me. I don't think so. Nothing on earth. Nothing on the face of the earth can impose fear on me because of the revelation of the word. The psalmist says, I shall not be afraid of the 10,000 of the army that surround me. Old Testament word. Saying that. Whose atonement was by the blood of bull and goat, but mine was by the blood of Jesus Christ. That was it. Even though I walk through the valley of shadow of death, I shall fear no evil. There are 100 scriptures that tell you about fear and fear. You know, I was traveling one day, we entered a bus, and somebody entered and said, everybody, bow your head. Every blood-sucking demon in this bus, I say, sit down. There's no blood-sucking demon. I mean, blood-sucking God. Every contrary spirit in this world, I say, see that, he said, contrary mind. That mind has to be renewed to the word of God. Yeah, you live your life with contrary mind. Can't you renew that? Can't you adjust and begin to process everything from the premise of the mind of Christ? Because the mind of Christ is getting to be in Christ. Oh, Pastor Jesus, God bless you for this. Pastor Jesus told me a story that he was, you know, he was casting out demons. Somebody that asked him, I can say, Pastor, I need any prayer. He said, he cast demons, I cast demons. After casting, he became angry. You are casting out angry. I don't know you're angry. Amen. Oh, are we blessed? Are we blessed today?
Yes, sir.
Let's appreciate Jesus. Let's appreciate him.
Thank you, Lord.
And thank God. Let's thank God for knowledge. Let's thank God for knowledge. Oh, please. You need revelation, knowledge. You need revelation. You need light. What you need is light. You need revelation. The eyes of your understanding be enlightened that you may know. Oh, Paul said, I desire that you might be filled with the knowledge of his will. In all wisdom and spiritual understanding. In all wisdom and spiritual understanding. I desire. It's my desire that you might be filled. I want you to be filled with the Spirit of God. They will open you up to the things that have been freely given to you in Christ. They will open you up to the true riches of Christ. Open up our head of the garden. 7 Peter chapter 1 verse 3. According as the divine power has given unto us. All tender pertaining to life and godliness through the night of him unto us, whereby I give unto us. These exceeding great precious promises, by these we escape the corruption that is in the world by law. We have escaped the corruption that is in the world by the care that is in Christ Jesus. We have all an eternal life. We pursue life. We pursue life and lay hold of life. We lay hold of life. We lay hold on life. We lay hold on life. We lay hold on life. That's what I'm going to do for my English worship. God's heart is to be worshiped every week. And thanks to the dedication of the child.
Oh,